Hey, CA. So I keep hearing people talking about the blessings of this time of quarantine. Time to relax, time with family, time to cook, time to do special projects, time to binge shows on Netflix, time to be in the Word, time to become a better person. And you know what? It annoys me because that has so not been my experience. I've spent a lot of time working really hard. I've spent a lot of time being frustrated. And honestly, I spent a lot of time being angry, not only at the situation we find ourselves in, but at the fact that I'm not doing a better job dealing with it. Can you relate? Now, what I'd like to tell you is that during the last 2 months, I felt my faith grow, and my doubts have evaporated, and my struggles have lessened, and my fears have subsided, and I've become a better Christian. But if I told you that, I'd be lying, because the truth is this. I am still a huge screw-up. I am still a poor, miserable sinner. And I'm guessing that some of you are feeling similar frustrations. If you're feeling to any extent unlovable, unsuccessful, or unworthy of God's favor, then this message is for you, my friends. It's okay to not be okay. You see, here's what gives me comfort. God's love, God's favor, and God's peace aren't reliant on us doing more stuff or being more faithful or being more morally excellent. Instead of falling into frustration and disappointment when our self-efforts fall short, we just need to surrender. Surrender and accept grace and freedom that come only from our Savior. Because none of us, and I mean none of us, is so broken, so unworthy, or struggling so much that we can't receive God's love and peace. Just surrender. The late, great Rich Mullins once said, "I think I would rather live on the verge of falling and let my security be in the all-sufficiency of the grace of God than to live in some kind of pietistic illusion of moral excellence. Not that I don't want to be morally excellent, but my faith isn't in the idea that I'm more moral than anybody else. My faith is in the idea that God and His love are greater than whatever sins any of us commit." In Matthew 11:28, Jesus didn't say, "Come to me, all you awesome believers who are living your best life, and I'll give you rest." Instead, He said, "Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest." I'd like to leave you with Rich Mullins' simple, short, powerful song, "Hold Me, Jesus." Let his lyrics be your prayer, as they've been mine. And whether you're weary and burdened because of your doubts, or because of your fears, or because of your actions, or for any other reason, just surrender. Surrender and ask Jesus to hold you. I can assure you, social distancing will not be an issue. Just ask Jesus to hold you.
Well, sometimes my life just don't make sense at all. When the mountains look so big, oh, my faith just seems so small. So hold me, Jesus, 'cause I'm shaking like a leaf. You have been King of my glory. Won't you be my Prince of Peace? And I wake up in the night and feel the dark. It's so hard inside my soul. I swear there must be blisters on my heart. So hold me, Jesus, 'cause I'm shaking like a leaf. You have been King of my glory. Won't you be my Prince of Peace? my head against so many walls. Now I'm falling down, I'm falling on my knees. And the Salvation Army band is playing this hymn. And your grace rings out so deep, it makes my resistance seem so thin. Prince of Peace, you have been King of my glory. Won't you be my Prince of Peace?